காவே சிகிரியே கட்ட பத்தாவுரே
With endless beaches, timeless ruins, herds of elephants, alluring landscapes, welcoming people, fun trains and delicious food, Sri Lanka is one of the few places in the world where nature's beauty remains abundant and unspoiled. No wonder it is one of the top tourist destinations amongst travelers from all around.
La, 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 la.
Hi, this is Sarita and Kamal. Welcome to Sri Lanka Travel Series on our travel channel. We have split up Sri Lanka travel guide in two parts. In this part one video, we are going to share with you some very important information about Sri Lanka that you must know before traveling to this island nation. In part two video, we will share with you a Sri Lanka travel itinerary that will help you cover major Sri Lanka attractions within a strict time frame. So don't forget to watch the second part after watching this. Hope this video will help you plan your trip wisely. Before we get started, hit the red subscribe button and the bell icon next to it to receive notifications from this channel and also follow us on Instagram and Facebook. And our name is World Kumo for both. Now let's begin with the travel guide. The tropical island nation of Sri Lanka, also known as the Pearl of the Indian Ocean, lies on the Indian tectonic plate in South Asia. It has a history dating back even as far back as 500,000 years and has had many names in the past. It was mentioned as Lanka in the Hindu epic Ramayana. The name Sri Lanka was adopted only in 1972. One of the first written references to the island is found in the Indian epic Ramayana, which provides details of a kingdom named Lanka that was created by the divine sculptor Vishwakarma for the gods. Lord Kuber seized control of Lanka and was later overthrown by his demon stepbrother Ravan. Geographically, Sri Lanka is separated from the mainland portion of the Indian subcontinent by the Gulf of Mannar and Palk Strait. According to the ancient Indian Sanskrit epic Ramayana written by Valmiki, a land bridge Ram Setu existed between the Indian mainland and Sri Lanka. Ramayana's Lanka Kand has detailed description about the bridge constructed by Sri Ram's Vanar Sena that allowed the army to reach Lanka and rescue Sri Ram's wife Mata Sita from Ravan. Satellite images showed the bridge. It starts as a chain from the Dhanushkodi tip of India's Pamban Island and ends at Sri Lanka's Mannar Island. It makes it to be one of the most earliest man-made bridges. Isn't that amazing? Now let's talk about the current situation in Sri Lanka, starting with religion. Sri Lanka is a multi-religious country. Buddhists comprise 70% of the population. Hinduism is the second most prevalent religion and is dominant in northern, central, and eastern Sri Lanka. Islam is the third most dominant religion in the country. Sinhalese and Tamil are the two official languages of Sri Lanka. English is widely used for education, scientific and commercial purposes. Sri Lanka's main economic sectors are tourism, clothing and tea export. It is also the world's second largest exporter of tea. Now talking about the climate in Sri Lanka. It is tropical and warm. The temperature remains fairly constant year-round, ranging from 26 to 32 degrees Celsius at coastal and lowland areas. At elevations, the temperature drops to 18 to 22 degrees Celsius. With that being said, the best time to visit Sri Lanka is between April to September. The best time to visit the beaches on the south and west coast is from December to March, when there is the least rain. October and November are often the wettest months in the area. Now let's move on to planning Sri Lanka vacation. Sri Lanka is one of the few places in the world that offers a stunning combination of countless pristine beaches, alluring landscapes, captivating cultural heritage, and numerous national parks within such a compact location. With so much to see and explore, one needs to pre-plan a trip to Sri Lanka months ahead. And the pre-planning stages include understanding Sri Lankan terrains and regions, planning an itinerary as per the number of days, booking flights, booking hotels, and arranging visa. Let's begin with Sri Lanka top places to visit region-wise. This will give you a fair idea about which region in Sri Lanka offers what and days required to explore each one of them. We have categorized the different regions based on the location of some of the most popular tourist attractions. Let's begin with the country's capital Colombo and Greater Colombo region. Colombo serves as both a getaway and stopover point for international tourists. It extends to Negombo in the north. Negombo is one of the most preferred stopover point for tourists traveling to Sri Lanka. This is the place you are most likely to spend your first day. Let's move on to the country's captivating historical sites. This region has the following World Heritage Sites, namely Sikiriya, Dambula, Habrana, Pulanaruwa, Kandy, Anuradhapura and Mitale. Sikiriya is famous for the astonishing Sikiriya Fortress. Dambula is known for its Dambula Cave Temple. Habrana village is known for elephant safaris and village tours. Ancient Pulanaruwa is popular for archaeological sites and ruins. Kandy is the home of the Temple of the Tooth Relic. Anuradhapura is popular for archaeological and architectural wonders. Mitale is known for its heritage center, temples and spice gardens. Beaches along the northern, eastern, western and southern coast of Jaffna, Negombo, Bentota, Arungam Bay, Nilavelli and many more are popular for surfing and vibrant nightlife, including the whale-watching triangle Mirisa, Kalpitaya and Trincomalee. Sri Lanka's countryside hills and tea gardens are located in Ella, Nuwara Eliya and Bandaravilla. These regions are popular for their scenic train rides, picturesque views, tea gardens and cool climate. Besides the heritage sites and beaches, Sri Lanka is also popular for its national parks. Sri Lanka has around 30 national parks, which is a big number for a small country. The most visited national parks in Sri Lanka are Yala National Park, Uduvali National Park, Minira and Kudulau National Park, Houghton Plains National Park and Singharaja Forest Reserve. These wildlife sanctuaries are home to leopards, elephants, a high diversity of mammals and birds. Bird watchers can go to either Bundala National Park, Kalamithia Bird Sanctuary or Anaviludava Sanctuary. Besides the various national parks and bird sanctuaries, the country also houses sea turtle hatcheries in Bentota and the popular Pinnavala Elephant Orphanage located in Pinnavala town near Kandy. These are a part of wildlife rescue and conservation program. The hatcheries aim to protect rescued sea turtles, and the Pinnavala Elephant Orphanage was founded to care and protect the many orphaned, unweaned wild elephants found wandering in and near the forest of Sri Lanka. Now moving on to the cities. Colombo, Kandy and Galle are some of the biggest cities in Sri Lanka that houses some of the other popular attractions. With so much to see and explore, one will need at least 1 month to fully explore Sri Lanka. However, one can get a glimpse of Sri Lanka and cover the major attractions within 2 weeks' time. This brings you to the next step, planning an itinerary according to the number of days you wish to travel. We have created an itinerary based on our personal travel experience, which you can check out after watching this video. You can find the video link in the description box below. Now, once you have made the itinerary, your next step should be booking flight tickets and hotels, both done at least 2 months ahead. Sri Lanka offers budget, luxury and backpacker hostels. If you choose top end luxury hotels and villas, Sri Lanka offers a lot for your money. Sri Lanka visa on arrival is available. One can also apply online. This process is called ETA, Electronic Travel Authorization. Sri Lanka currency is Sri Lankan rupee, LKR. You can easily withdraw money from the ATMs in Sri Lanka. It will be good to carry some USD currency before landing. Getting around Sri Lanka is pretty easy. Best way to see Sri Lanka is independent travel. Tuk-tuk, the three-wheel bikes are easily available and the drivers can take you to any location easily. They can, however, be more expensive than buses. Buses are the second option but can be time-consuming. You can board a train to travel from one city to the other. Train rides can be a lot of fun but again, they can be a bit time-consuming. A rented car with hired driver can be the best option to travel safe and fast within a city and from one to another. You can book the cabs through your hotels, by travel agents or by booking on the spot once you reach Sri Lanka. It would be best to book everything in advance. If you book cabs, here is one point you need to keep in mind. We recommend collecting all the entry tickets including the safari tickets on your own and do not rely on the drivers to get them for you. Drivers are most likely to keep 30% as their commission. We have mentioned the rates of all the safaris and entry fees to all the attractions on our website. Please go through the blog post for more information. Link is in the description box. If you plan to stay for longer duration, renting a bike can be a good option. The bikes are easily available on almost every street. Sri Lankan people in general are warm and welcoming. Regardless of which region you are in Sri Lanka, the first thing that will catch your attention is lotus flowers and lotus ponds. They are found everywhere in Sri Lanka, outside the temples, along the roadsides, inside the national parks and even in the center of the city. Apart from the lotuses, you will also come across street vendors selling king coconut water. Trust me, it was the sweetest we have ever had. Colorful fruit stalls are yet another captivating sights you will come across in Sri Lanka. Let's move on to shopping in Sri Lanka. From intricate handicrafts to vibrant clothes and decorative home interiors, indulge into some best shopping experiences in Sri Lanka. Numerous shops along the lanes of the famous beaches and tourist attractions sell a variety of items that you can pick as souvenirs. Remember to always carry some cash since cards may not be accepted at many shops. Check your country's custom and important regulations before making any purchase. Sri Lanka,
la 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 la.
Sri Lanka nightlife is most liveliest in the beaches of Negombo, Bentota, Marisa and other coastal towns. It's all about partying, dancing and indulging into some delicious seafood. In the other regions, it's all about more relaxed evenings and easygoing nights. Now let's talk about Sri Lankan food. Sri Lankan cuisine is a blend of South Indian and Indonesian cuisines with a tinge of Dutch flavors in it. A typical Sri Lankan breakfast includes string hoppers, fresh coconut, sambal and dal. Rice curry is one of the most popular Sri Lankan cuisine along with a variety of rotis, seafood and other dishes. Besides themed restaurants spread out across the island, some cool open kitchens and hippie eateries can be found in all the cities. People who are 100% vegetarians like ourselves might struggle a bit since the restaurants have very limited vegetarian food options. However, there are a couple of Indian restaurants one needs to find out in advance and plan accordingly. Now, addressing to one of the most important questions, how much Sri Lanka costs? It will depend on a number of factors. Read our blog post where we have mentioned the following expenditure breakdown. Since it is not possible to include all the information in this video, we have therefore mentioned some additional very important tips and information one needs to know before traveling to Sri Lanka in the blog post. We highly recommend you to go through it after watching this video. That's all for this video. Watch the part 2 video to check out our travel itinerary. Leave us a comment and let us know how you found this video. Give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and we will catch you soon in our next video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.